Methanogenic Raman microbes and methane inhibition. Methanogenic archaea are responsible for methane generation in the human. Usually one particular microbe, when increases or decreases in the ecosystem, their products always increase or decrease accordingly. But in the case of methanogens, they do not have any correlation with the methane generated in the human. Methane production in the human is an essential evil. During fermentation of feed, particularly the roughage-based diet in the rumen, a lot of molecular hydrogen is produced, which has a high octane value and is highly combustible, which might be very dangerous. In addition to hydrogen, carbon dioxide, volatile fatty acids, and a small quantity of other products are also produced. The methanogens convert carbon dioxide and hydrogen to a less dangerous gas, that is methane. Hydrogen utilizers convert these gases into short-chain fatty acids, which can be used as energy source by the animals. Methanogenesis causes harmful effect in two ways, increasing the global warming and decreasing the feed efficiency. Then there are culturable rumen methanogens. Only 5 genera and 8 species of rumen methanogens have been cultivated in vitro in the present techniques available in science. These are Methanobacterium, Methanobrevibacter, Methanomicrobium, Methanopuleus, Methanosarcina, etc. When we use the metagenomic techniques, methanogens and hydrogen utilizer in the buffalo, it has been reported that there are 18 methane generating bacteria and 5 hydrogen utilizing bacteria, which can use hydrogen and carbon dioxide and convert it into volatile fatty acids, which can be used as a source of energy. The methane production on different feeds, the straws are the highest methane producers and the concentrates the lowest producers. Other feeds lie in between these two extremes. The selection of feed ingredients is very important for lower methane generation by the livestock. If we compare two different animal species, that is yak and cattle, we find that when they are fed the similar diets, there is more methane generation in cattle than that in yak. But the number of methanogens was equal in both the species. Hydrogen producers were higher in cattle. Therefore, it appears that high hydrogen production and high hydrogen producing microbial numbers were better correlated with methane generation, while the methanogen numbers were not correlated with methane generation. With the plant secondary metabolites, the methanogen depression was between 36 to 96% in vitro conditions, and in vivo experiments, methane inhibition was from 10 to 29% with the same inhibitors. The rumen manipulation showed a significant inhibition in methane emission, while there was only a slight improvement in digestibility. There was 24% inhibition in methane production on high roughage diet, and there was 20.4% inhibition in methanogenesis on low roughage diets. There was no effect of diet on total methanogens estimated by real-time PCR technique. No effect of diet on methanogens. There was high abundance, 47 versus 43% of the methanobrevibacter in 70% TDN diet. Methanospirillum and methanococci high in 100% diet, TDN diet. Archaeal diversity was more with high fiber diet, that is 70% of the TDN requirement. There was no difference in other methanogens in all the diets. There appears to be no correlation of methanogens with methane emission. The constraints which we have observed for in vivo methane inhibition are lack of precise methane emission techniques, limited in vivo studies, complex rumen microbial ecosystem, no correlation between methanogens and methanogenesis, positive correlation between hydrogen producers and methanogenesis. Other studies might also show different correlations than the reported so far. The strategies for the reduction of methane emission by the animals is lignocellulosic feeds produce more methane as compared to cereal grain or concentrates. If you replace straws with the grain in the ration, methane emission per kg feed intake is reduced considerably, but it has a competition with human beings for food and feed. The other strategies include the feed additives containing plant secondary metabolites and terminal electron acceptors, which can be used for inhibition of methanogenesis in the ruminants. The future work includes that the microbiome and the enzyme profile of the rumen needs to be identified for feed degradation and inhibit methanogenesis to make the livestock production economic and environmental friendly. There are many feed supplements and feed combinations which can inhibit methanogenesis. There are only a few plants like Terminalia chebula and Allium stivum which stimulate fiber degradation too, in addition to the methane inhibition they have in the rumen. The phytochemicals can be used to inhibit methanogenesis, but in vivo experiments are required on large number of animals for longer duration before final recommendation. Defoundation has a proven effect on inhibiting methane emission method of defoundation, and to keep the defaunated animals needs to be studied.